everyone. This is Katie from On a Good Note Music Therapy Services. Over the past 2 weeks, we've been covering some things on the blog about being a traveling music therapist. I've shared some of my favorite tips as to how to better manage your life as a traveling music therapist, some of my favorite apps, and some resources that you can use along your travels. Today, I was packing up all of my stuff for my normal travels and thought, there's a lot of things here that I've had to learn over the past couple years and things that I could probably share with some of you. So stay tuned and I am going to show you some of what I do to help keep myself sane while I am traveling. Okay, first things first. There are three essentials that I cannot live without when I'm on the road. The first is my coffee. As all of my students know, I drink a lot of coffee because I am always going between houses, then I come home and I have to document or I'm packing things up or learning new songs. When you own your business, work doesn't really end. You don't really have set hours. So I live off of coffee. But Starbucks gets really expensive, so I try to pack my own coffee and tea before I leave the house. And the second thing is my watch. Now, I was never a watch person before I started going to people's homes, but they don't always have clocks in the room that you're going to be teaching in, and pulling out your phone in the middle of sessions gets incredibly distracting. So I started wearing a watch to be less distracting to my students, to work on time management, and for my own personal needs, because sometimes I need to see what's going on, or time different interventions or behaviors. So I wear a watch all the time now. And the third thing, which I don't have with me, is my lunchbox. It's really cute, Vera Bradley, but stopping for snacks along the way or eating out every day of the week is, first of all, unhealthy, and second of all, it gets super expensive, and you don't always have time to stop. So I always pack several snacks or a full lunch that I can eat along the way between my stops. So the next thing, after those three essentials that I cannot live without, I have several different bags for all my stuff. The first one that I have is my teaching bag. Now, in my teaching bag, I keep the basics for what I need in my lessons and in my sessions, as well as all my teaching materials. So here's a quick thing. This bag is super heavy, but has tons and tons of pockets, side pockets, front pockets, interior pockets, zippered things. It's awesome. Could not live without it. So in here I keep all my art supplies, all of my post-its, and my headphones, my scissors. I keep paper, blank paper, because it always comes in handy. I keep a pocket with tuners, multiple tuners and metronomes, pens and pencils in another pocket. I keep my sticker box for all my students as rewards. I keep a mileage book for keeping my mileage along the way. My iPad, which I use it as a reward at the end of my sessions or to help reinforce certain behaviors. I also use it with some of my interventions. I have my daily binder. Now, I at one point had a big binder with all of my stuff, but I decided to break it down into each day of the week. So on my floor over here, I have a binder for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, etc. And that way I just have to take what I need for those students and I can prep exactly what I'll have for each of them in my binder. Okay, keep it on going. In here, I also keep a pad of paper, because it always comes in handy. You sometimes need to take notes, like within a session or a lesson, and I keep a bottle of water. I'm sure there's more. I think I also have some kazoos and some small rhythm instruments, like a couple egg shakers and a castanet to help work on things like rhythm. Sometimes using those manipulatives is really good, even for some of my lesson students, to help motivate them to work on the rhythm aspects of a song or to help reinforce some of the concepts that we're learning. So that's bag number one. Here comes two. All right, we're back. Bag number two is super bright, super colorful, and again, tons of pockets. My bag also has some zippered sections for those kids who like to get into things and maybe you want to keep them a little separate. So I have a large zippered pocket where I can zip up the things that I don't want my clients to touch. What's nice is also, since I have so many pockets, I can divide up my bag by types of instruments. So in my front pocket, I can keep things like egg shakers and then larger maracas in the next pocket. In the side, I can do things like castanets, and then I can do larger instruments in the interior pockets. I can also have one on the side here for things like mallets, and I can keep some cards and whatever else I need in this back zipper. So I'm always looking for the right bag to keep my instruments in. Another thing I use is actually a coupon holder. This might seem silly, but it's super small and very portable, and it's really good for keeping those paper things that you use in some of your sessions, like color cards. Or I did one Thanksgiving Day intervention that had turkeys. Recently, I also did one with snowflakes, so you can use things like this with my song Counting Snowflakes and keep them in this lovely little coupon holder that I got for probably a dollar. So it stays small, portable, well organized, and fits easily in either my teaching or my instrument bag. Also behind me are the rest of my instruments. So sometimes I'll also need to take my bongos or my djembe or my ukulele, my guitar. Sometimes I also add bells. And then, of course, I also have my purse. So I have three bags, sometimes a backpack, my lunchbox, a larger instrument like a guitar, and drums. So it takes several trips to get out to the car, but packing it ahead of time, like the night before, like I did just now, is super helpful. Okay, so we're gonna wrap it up here in just a minute. So I hope you've really enjoyed my quick insight into all of the different bags I use and the ways that I help organize myself so that I'm not losing track of things during my sessions and I can be better prepared. I would love to hear any ways that you keep yourself organized while you're on the road and any tips or tricks that you might have to share with others. Have a wonderful rest of your week, and thanks for watching.